Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about Mendel's law of inheritance. To be precise, we will be talking about the monohybrid cross, which led to the proposal of law of segregation. So in the slide, what you can see is the picture of Gregor Johann Mendel. He was a renowned mathematician, then he was a meteorologist as well as a very famous biologist. Gregor Johann Mendel is also known as the father of genetics. Towards the right, what you can see is the picture of a pea plant. So that is the plant with which Gregor Johann Mendel worked and led to the establishment of the law of inheritance. So besides this, he deduced that genes comes in pairs and are inherited as a discrete units from each parent. So he conducted your hybridization experiments on garden peas for 7 years. Now, Gregor Johann Mendel was very smart in selecting the plant material because he selected a pea plant, which is an annual plant and completes its life cycle in 1 year. Now, during his tenure, he could study so many generation of pea plants because of this particular advantage of an annual plant, and he proposed the law of inheritance. So let us see the cross. This is your monohybrid cross. Now the term mono means, please keep that in mind, mono means one. So in this particular monohybrid cross, only one trait is taken into consideration, that is your height of the plant. Now if you see the heights are tall and dwarf plant. So in the parental generation, what you see, they are tall plant crossed with a dwarf plant. Now here if you see, the alleles are capital T, small t, small t. So please keep that in mind. In genetics, capital letters basically denotes a dominant trait or dominant allele. So alleles are nothing but the different versions of a gene. Now this when you cross a parental generation, that is tall plant with a dwarf plant, basically in the first step is that the formation of gametes. Now gametes, as you know, are the product of meiosis. So at anaphase, this will go to the opposite pole and the gametes will be produced. Now since in this case, if you see capital T, so both of them will go to two different poles or opposite poles and form gametes. Now the gametes will be of one type only, that is capital T in this case. So that's why we are taking only one, that is your capital T. In case of dwarf, we are using the term small t, so we are getting one small t. So those are the gametes. Those gametes will fuse to form a offspring or F1. Okay, F1 is first filial generation. So you get capital T and small t. Now see, in this case, although capital letter T is there, which clearly shows that all the phenotypes in F1 generation will be tall. However, they are heterozygous. Had it been capital T, then it would have been homozygous. Now the next step is your selfing. Selfing basically means F1 cross with F1. Now you see, this F1 has capital T, small t, so we are crossing two F1, so capital T, small t cross with a capital T, small t. There also what will happen, there will be meiosis and all those, and ultimately gametes will be formed. Now here you see, we are taking two types of alleles, that is two types of gametes to be specific. If you see capital T, small t, because they will move to opposite pole and two types of gametes are produced. So you see in the first one, F1 only capital T, small t types of gametes, and the other one also capital T, small t gametes. Now we go for a checkered board where we place the gametes along the side. So you see capital T is placed, red color one, along one side, and capital T, that is for one gender, or that is in this case it's female. Then the on the other side is a male gametes, that is capital T, small t. Now you cross them again, capital T will fuse with capital T, we'll get capital T, capital T. The next one, capital T fuses with a small t, so you're getting capital T, small t. The next one is your capital T fuses with small t, so you get capital T, small t. And the last one is your small t fuses with small t, so you get small t, small t. Now if you see in the first one, capital T, capital T, these are homozygous, that means they are of same alleles are there. Now in the next case, you see capital T, small t, capital T, small t. So in this case, what you are getting is a basically you're getting heterozygous, although capital T is there. So we choose that this particular phenotypic expression will be tall, or those two offspring will be tall. And the last one is your small t is recessive. So both the small t's are there. That's why you're getting homozygous dwarf. So this monohybrid cross led to the proposal of the law of segregation, in which during the formation of gamete, each gene separates from each other so that each gamete carries only one allele for each gene. Now you know alleles are basically in the different positions of a gene. Now if you see the picture towards your right, that is the checkered box. We have made it very simple. Here what I tried to do is that if you see, I have made three red color ones, and a black line is also there to indicate that in this checkered box you can see that three red color ones where at least one of the dominant allele is present. So in this case the dominant allele is T, and the last one, which is of a blue color, in there what you get is a recessive allele. So if you see the from this particular box also, you can see that there will be the phenotypic ratio will be three tall and one dwarf. So this was all about in brief about your monohybrid cross. Thank you and have a nice time.